Hey, my name is Gala, and today I would like to review my Google Data Studio template that calls weekly cohort analysis. This is nice type of analysis when we can observe different cohort of users and see how do they behave, how long do they stay with us, and this is really nice. Usually I saw monthly cohorts, but in this case we have weeks. And it's fine, and of course you can decide which cohort do you need, depend on your business. And here we can see that we have title in this report, we have some subtitle with some explanation what do we have here, and the first part with numbers that calls weekly cohort analysis all countries. It means that below we will have the same analysis split by countries. You scroll down and see we have country filter. Here we have date range picker, and we can choose different data range. Here, just click here, I don't know, March 31st, okay. For example, 1st of April, 30th of April, perfect. We have only 1 month, for example. Or we can select this year, this month, this quarter, this year. Okay, nice. On this pivot table, we can see that, for example, on the weeks that started 20 of March 2022, we got 82 new users. 100% of them made purchase on the week zero. It is normal because we count users who made the first purchase during this week. And further, we can see that some of them made the last purchase on this week seven, some of them made the last purchase on week 13, etc. So by this number, we can know how long usually users stay with us, when they did the first purchase and when they did the last purchase. It is an interesting metric because we can, when we work with lifetime value, when we work with, when we open new offices, when you launch new products or taste marketing hypothesis, it's really interesting how it, does it have any influence for our clients or not? So how long do they stay with us? And it's a really nice metric. Below we have charts that show repeat data that we have in a pivot table. But we have two charts here. We have, for example, here we have only percentage. For example, during this period we had 771 users, and here we have only percentage of them, so 10% of users made the last purchase during the 10 weeks, but we don't know how many of them. So if we go here, we can see that week 10, 90 users, and means 67 users. Interesting why data is a bit different, but okay. If we scroll down, we can see the same charts but split it by countries. We have country filter and we can choose different countries and see how behave users in different countries. I chose country, but in your case it could be managers, for example, how long users stay with different managers, or stores, or regions, or any other parameters that you want to split your customers. The same chart here. So I think you like it. I hope you like it, and it's really nice kind of report. Let's check what do we have in the backend. I click to edit the report, and here is actually it's the same, but we just can change it. Let's go to resources, manage edit data sources, and As you see, here we have two data sources, and two of them are Google Sheets. Let's check, what do we have in this Google Sheets? In this Google Sheets that I connected to the template, we have four tabs. The first tab is the most interested in, because here we have the raw data based on which data we can create this kind of report. The data actually is super simple, just order date, order ID, user ID, and country, or any parameter, as I said. This data you can pull from Google Analytics or CRM system. It absolutely depend on data that you have. Just load data to Google Sheets. Then we work with this data, we do some calculations. Okay, country, it is like it was. User ID, the same, but we already do some calculations. We count unique country and user ID, And for each user ID, we calculate the last day of purchase and the first day when this client made the first purchase. And based on this data, we can calculate user age, so how long users stayed with us in day, in month, and in weeks, because it is a weekly cohort analysis. Then we create pivot table based on this data. When we don't need user ID here, but we count the number of users, the number of unique users for each week, for each cohort and each country. Then we work with this pivot table and do some transformation here, count users for week zero and join data from week zero with data from other weeks. Also, we create two tables that we can upload to Google Data Studio. This will be the first table with country column, and this will be the second table without country column. There are some moments why we cannot do it in one table. You will get the wrong percentage if you use it in the same table. But don't worry, I already tried several times and decided, so okay, better to have two tables, and it works better in this case. That is it. So we connect to Google Data Studio this table from AC to AG, and this table with country breakdown from R to Z. Formulas that I use in this Google Sheet, you can find in the article. The link to the article will be below the video, so you can check formulas, and I think it will be more useful if you see formulas than if I read it for you, because it's difficult to read sometimes, difficult to understand formulas when you read it. And maybe one moment that I would like to note here, when we connect data source, we can click edit connection. When we connect Google Sheet, we can select data range that we want to connect. So with this moment, I can choose two different tables from one tab in Google Sheet. So that is it. Hope you like my overview and my template. Please feel free to ask me questions. Feel free to leave comments, and it will be really nice to hear feedback. And I will try to make more of use, because I have a lot of nice templates that I already created for my clients, and I would like to share some knowledge about my work. So, hope you like it, and bye-bye.